Hi! This laser was advertised as an 80 to 100 milliwatts yellow-green laser. Sadly, mine measures less than 30. Nothing new in being disappointed with an online seller. However, at the end of my video on yellow lasers, I noticed that this laser was delivered with the wrong power supply. The online listing was at some point changed to 12 volts, 3 amps. The delivered one is only 2 amps. Is this laser simply not getting enough juice to reach full power? Will this unbranded power supply even deliver the 2 amps as labeled? And is it possible for a noob like me to build something that can adjust the laser's power output? Time to find out! When using a high-powered laser, always wear proper laser safety glasses matching the wavelength and power of the laser. Why would they make an obvious change in the specs on the power supply and then deliver one not matching the change? Was it upgraded from 2 amps to 3 amps since they found out that the 2 amp version I have received was not sufficient for this laser? These thoughts have haunted me since I saw the delivered power supply is not 3 amps. I would like to know if it matters or not. One thing I've learned over the years from working with cheap, unbranded lasers is never trust the label. It's just a sticker. I wonder if this generic power supply will even deliver 2 amps or is it only wishful thinking? Luckily, I have the right tool for testing its max power after making a video about this very topic, an electronic load. I just need to find a way to hook it up to this plug. That will do. Just making sure it isn't shorted. Looks fine. I'll hook it up. Center positive. Oh, the power supply is at 1.7 volts without even being plugged into mains power. Guess they didn't bother with a bleeder resistor to discharge the output capacitor inside the power supply. Quality. Ah well, at least it does have an output capacitor. Since I'm focused on amperes, current, I will set the electronic load to constant current mode. I will start at a modest 100 milliamps. Okay, with the power supply plugged in, but no load on it yet. The voltage is now at 12.3. Good starting point. Let me switch the load on. Can we draw 0.1 ampere from the power supply? Yes. Time to increase the load in 100 milliamps increments until we reach the labeled 2 amps. Will the power supply give up before that? Nice. The power supply will provide 2 amps, though it is struggling a bit with the 12 volts at this point. What if I go just a little beyond? Oh shoot, it did not like that. The output is gone and the LED is blinking. I hope this signals protection mode, not game over. A power cycle will tell us which it is. And it's back at 2 amps. Phew! Alright, makes me wonder how much current the laser module draws from this power supply. I am stopping the laser beam with a beam dump I made in 2 earlier videos, links in the description. Oh well, the power supply is only using 3.4 watts, meaning the laser module is only drawing around 2.7 watts or 225 milliamps from it, including a 1.2 watts cooling fan, as I will show later. Leaving only around 1.5 watts to the laser driver and pump diode. This tells me there is no reason to use a 3 amps adapter for this particular laser module. It doesn't matter, I only got a 2 amps version. The laser module is far from limited by this adapter. I have to accept that my specimen of this laser module will not deliver 80 to 100 milliwatts. but I think I may be able to adjust the laser's power in another way. Next to the power connector is a second connector marked TTL, and more importantly, PWM further down. PWM stands for pulse width modulation and is a common way of adjusting a laser's power. My 10 years old Arduino Uno will do PWM on its outputs marked with a tilde sign. I just need to figure out how it all works. After an online search, link in the description, I found a useful project guiding me in the right direction. Looks relatively simple. PWM only uses two pins, a plus 5 volts and a ground. But this connector has 3 pins. Hard to tell which two I should use. No documentation came with the laser or in the online listing. I will have to disassemble the module for a closer look at the board. Pro tip, do not push on this heatsink. It is only held in place by thermal paste and easily snaps off. I had to replace the dried up thermal paste on mine to make it stick again. Here we go. Now, what do we have here? I see a line going to the center pin and the text plus ground PWM. Not super clear what that marked center pin is. Maybe the backside is marked in a better way. Nope, but it is more helpful. Notice how two of the pins seem to be connected directly via copper layers to plus and ground on the 12 volts power connector. A multimeter can confirm this. Yep. The center pin is ground, and the right pin is a second plus 12 volts power option. The left pin is not connected directly to the power plug, so by elimination, it must be the plus 5 volts pin for the PWM signal. Great! Time to build the circuit. That was easy. Before I hook it up to the expensive laser, I am just making a final check. Do note that a PWM signal really should be measured on an oscilloscope, but I don't have one yet. Comment if you can recommend a reasonably priced model with a video-friendly large and clear screen. The 2.5 volts measured here should in reality be the average of 0 and 5 volts on a 50% duty cycle. Hard to confirm on a multimeter alone, but as far as I can tell, my pulse width modulator is ready for use. Will it work? Okay, the Arduino and power bank turned off just as the laser was powered up. This happened several times, and even without the laser connected. Not sure what caused this. Looks like a power issue, so I may have had a bad connection from dust, corrosion, metal flaking, static electricity, or whatever. The problem disappeared by itself later, but I managed to get some good runs showing it does work, as long as the Arduino is powered. I can now adjust the laser power from 0 milliwatts to the laser's max at around 30 milliwatts. Pretty handy. For example, for aligning the laser beam at a low, safer level and then dial the power up once set up. I did see some unwanted laser blinking, but only at full power. Again, probably because of the power issue, but it made me realize how convenient it would be to have some kind of readout from the Arduino. What level is the laser set at? After a short but important message, I will implement an LCD screen to the Arduino and program. A big, big thanks to all my patrons. I appreciate your help with keeping these videos like this one coming. For just a dollar a month, you can help me out too and get full access to all my posts on patreon.com. Link in the description. Thank you. Alright, after following the instructions in the starter kit and adding some lines to the program, I now have a readout of the setting. And with the power issue gone, it works perfectly. Check this out. I will not go through the whole setup, but I would like to point out some things. The second dial is for adjusting the screen's contrast. Without some sort of delay on the refresh of the screen, I was having some issues with reading it. The setting often ends in a position where it flickers between two values. With a compromise, a refresh delay of 300 milliseconds in my case, I am able to see what two numbers it flickers between, without feeling too much of a delay between the dial and screen. Occasionally, I also had an issue with the pot in max position. The duty cycle was sometimes flickering between 99 and 100%, so I rather brutally added a line where 99 is set to 100. Not elegant, I know. I am planning to add two physical switches. One that in the program will override the pot and go directly to a setting of 100%, full power. And another that goes directly to 0%, laser beam off. I will also add a visual bar graph for the power setting on the LCD screen. That is the beauty of DIY. You can make it work in the way you want it to. I really enjoyed this build. Hope you enjoyed this video enough to click like and perhaps subscribe for more like it. In any case, thanks for watching. Bye for now.